Now sit back and enjoy as the International Animated Film Society, ASIFA-Hollywood, proudly presents the 37th Annual Annie Awards. Please welcome a previous of Iwerks recipient and the president of Walt Disney and Pixar Animation Studios, Ed Catmull.
Thank you. I'm delighted to be here tonight to present the of Iwerks Award for Technical Achievement to my friend and colleague, Bill Reeves. When you say particle, you think of something tiny and insignificant. But when you say particle systems, however, you've gone global. Bill Reeves was the pioneer and he's the one instrumental in developing particle systems for computer graphics and for animation. It enables animators to create convincing fireworks and smoke and fire and rain and fog and dust. The first use in a motion picture was for Star Trek, The Wrath of Khan. It was that wall of fire that swept across the planet. And it was so impactful at the time that the clip from that effect was used in the next three Star Trek movies. Bill wrote the foundational paper for this important tool. And what's more, Bill was one of the principal architects of MenVi. That's the modeling and animation environment that allowed Pixar to make the first CGI feature film, Toy Story, as well as every subsequent Pixar film. I think it's safe to say that he's had quite an effect on the industry. Without Bill's contributions for nearly a quarter of a century, we wouldn't be here. Today, Bill remains Pixar's technical guru. He embodies the deepest and broadest understanding of our entire production process. His work has helped us realize the vision of our filmmakers. He also continues to provide mentorship and training and teaching for the other people in the studio. And his work continues to change the way our films are made. It is a tremendous honor for me to present ASIFA-Hollywood's of Iwerks Award to Bill Reeves.
Thank you very much. It was a great opportunity when Ed called me. I was in graduate school back at the University of Toronto and said, do you want to work on some Star Wars stuff with us and, you know, and head up an R&D group at Lucasfilm, and it was like a dream come true. And 30 years later, it's been a long road, and it's been an awesome road, of course. We've done a lot of amazing things along the way. And we've had a lot of amazing people as part of that group. And I think that was one of the big reasons why, I was successful and other people were successful, was the great team Ed put together. The thing that we really learned by working together was, if I could write programs that had, sort of inputs and controls that creative people and myself and anybody could control this beast, this technology, that you could then broaden it and you could take it step by step and step. And if a director said, well, could you just, we could sort of say, yeah, we can, sure, we'll go in and, but John Lasseter arrived on the scene and he pitched the idea of Andre and Wally B in the 1984 era, a while ago now. But today I get kids coming up to me today and said, I read your paper and I implemented particle systems. And I said, great, great, great. And they whip out their iPhone and they show me, and we were using this huge monster computer back at the time to do it. They got it right there in their iPhone. So I really, truly want to thank ASIFA for this great honor. Quite surprised by it, but it's a great honor. It's a great honor to, of all the people in technology that work sort of behind the scenes to help bring the movies to life. I want to thank Ed, he's our silent leader. He's the smart guy, in behind John Lasseter, who brought creative vision and passion to our studio. Eben Ospie, who I worked with for many, many years as a technologist. And I can go on and on. Many, many people worked in technology at Pixar, and in some sense, this is an honor for them as well. So this is to my family and everyone else I mentioned. Thank you very much.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Frank Gladstone.
Hi, everybody. How are you? More than 35 years ago, I started out as a stop-motion animator, and maybe that's why this year's Annie Award for Special Achievement means so much to me. It goes to two gentlemen who combine technical wizardry with artistry in a unique and truly startling way for the film Coraline. Brian McLean and Martin Meunier developed the rapid phototyping process through which, for example, the original sculptured faces of a stop-motion figure served as a basis for the computer creation of the multiple replacement faces and props, which were ultimately rendered as 3D physical objects to be used in the technique of stop-motion. Their work for Coraline results in characters with an amazing range of expression that never overwhelms the painstaking, artful, hands-on animation technique. For the development of the rapid prototyping process, ASIFA-Hollywood is honored to present the Annie Award for Special Achievement to Martin Meunier and Brian McLean.
Pretty cool. Stop motion animation lives on, yes. Which is great. And we want to thank especially Henry Selick, because he's the one who believed in it. He had the original idea, and he basically let us do it, and it was a big chance he took, but I think we, made it work with a lot of people who helped.
Yeah, and I would also like to thank Travis Knight, Phil Knight, Claire Jennings for their continued support of this process. We had an entire crew of over 35 technicians and artists who helped with this whole process also.
Painters and sculptors, and it went from Shane Prigmore all the way down the line to Travis Knight, who animated, so it was a huge process.
Everything needed to be hand-sanded and hand-painted, so 12,000 pieces were pretty easily rendered on the 3D printer, but they all had to be meticulously cared for. So
a hands-on approach.
Yes.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.